August 31st, 1999. Took 5 days to drive from Toronto to Edmonton. Turned out to be exactly 3,600 kilometers from door to door. It was a beautiful day, just like it is today. Sunny, and it was just like, wow, welcome to Edmonton. The club here, Juventus, has adopted me right from day one, get-go, when I came here.
Come on now! Come on!
I think it was January 2nd of 2000 when I officially started training with Steen.
Faster. That was good.
He's a competent and awesome cyclist as well. And his vision was really similar and same to mine.
85%, 85%, 85%.
And then there.
Light it up 100%. So boom, in the saddle.
He started, you know, working out the nitty-gritty and just really fine-tuning. Yeah, I want to go to the Olympics.
Down the back stretch. Muenzer looking very comfortable as they're neck and neck coming through the final corner. Here they come. Muenzer,
God, August 2002. So, ruptured appendix started way after the Commonwealth Games. But I knew something was up, but I didn't think anything like that. Took one sip of coffee and I went, it's time to go to the hospital. It just, you know when something just isn't right. So went to the hospital. 16 hours later, they took me in to be operated. Even then, at that point, they weren't sure if it was a ruptured appendix or not. And when I came out, I sure was feeling better. But unfortunately, I wasn't able to do the World Championships that year.
Just to be here is a success story for Lorianne. She's done a tremendous amount of work. She's overcome a tremendous amount of adversity to get here.
In track cycling, there's no room for error. You don't have, you know, 100 kilometers, 140 kilometers to go from point A to point B. I've got 3 laps, and you can't make one mistake. You can't be sleeping. You got to be so alert. You got to be ready to go. And that's just the way it is. I don't want to let anybody down. I want to be able to do the best job that I can possibly do. And it'll be time to put it together. And the days that I'm racing, those are going to be the days where it really counts the most.
It's hardwood at a 42-degree angle. The arena of the fastest athletes at the Olympics. Charging across the boards at over 70 kilometers an hour, it's human-powered NASCAR racing. There's the new champion in the women's event. Anna Mears captured the world title in her home country of Australia 3 months ago. Lorianne Muenzer carries Canada's colors at the track. Since her first Olympics in Sydney, she's brought home 4 world championship medals. Now she wants to get one at the Olympics, too. Yang Zhaozhang of China is the world record holder in the 500-meter time trial, but she's still looking for her first Olympic medal. Twice around the track, a race against the clock. One chance at Olympic glory. So Muenzer will lead this one out. And I think she will want to stay in the front.
And Lorianne is, and you can see it's quite evident in that picture right there, just the size difference between these two riders. And Lorianne has just shown such great power and such great dominance over her opponents when she does use it to her advantage. And she's a difficult rider to pass through these turns. These turns are not easy to pass your opponent on at all at any other given point in time, let alone the substantial size difference between these two riders. And Lorianne has just impressed everybody with her ability to control the race.
Fairly high pace so far, halfway through. Lorianne continues in the front, Abasobu behind her. Now she goes up a little bit on the track. Lorianne continues to have a look at her from behind. There they get the bell for the final lap.
Lorianne's got this race in great control. It's going to take everything of Abasobu's got to throw at her to try to beat her, but Lorianne looks way too strong.
Muenzer responding now, still with the lead coming through the final corner. Abasobu will try to kick behind her now. She knows she's got it. Here comes Muenzer, and she is the gold medal winner for Canada. Lorianne Muenzer comes through and wins it 2 straight over Abasobu.
What a dominant show of force. She really came into this competition with such confidence. She knew what she was doing. She was so happy. Mark, I cannot think of a better or more deserving gold medalist than Lorianne Muenzer. She's personable. She's graceful. She's humble. And for her, this victory is really the process or the end of a long road, a long journey. She has fought back from injury, from illness, and really came here to this competition so prepared, so confident in her abilities, and man, she did not disappoint anyone.
Lorianne Muenzer, the first ever gold medalist in cycling for Canada. And all her friends at Edmonton right now have got to be cheering as Lorianne takes a victory lap with the Canadian flag. And her friends and family also in Toronto. She's originally from Toronto, now living in Edmonton for the past 5 years, cycling for the Juventus Cycling Club.
Gold medal and Olympic champion, representing Canada, Lauri-Anne Muenzer.
I'm going to say a phrase to you, and I want you to tell us how it sounds. Lauri-Anne Muenzer, Canada's first ever gold medalist in cycling.
That's so cool. It's just everything just seems to be in slow motion. Unbelievable. I feel like I found the pot of gold at the end of the rainbow. I mean, this is 10 years, 5 years of working with a guy, Steve Madsen, who's crazy enough as I was to think and dream about going to the Olympics. And working with him, over 5 years, up and down, up and down. And it's just been great.